today I'm going to talk about Brookline's Coolidge Corner, a great place, a mecca for restaurant goers, indie movie theater fans, just everyday shopping, city shopping, not a lot of large chains. So stick with me and I will be right back. Get there by car. Jamaica Way by car. There's parking at Coolidge Corner. The 65 or 66 bus by trolley on the Green Line C, which goes down Beacon Street. You know when you're there by the big landmark building called the S.S. Pierce Building. It was built in 1897. I went to Coolidge Corner on a Saturday morning to take a few pictures for this video. It was 26 degrees. It was about 11 o'clock. I was shocked. There were people actually sitting outside coffee shops having coffee. A lot of activity. The trolley went by. People were jumping off the trolley to do their errands. People, it was almost like all the apartment buildings were emptying out and moving to Coolidge Corner. Along Beacon Street and Harvard Street, where they intersect, there was a lot of activity because there's lots of coffee shops, bakeries, little shops, baby clothes, an indoor arcade with restaurants and shops like a tailor and a Japanese restaurant. In this densely packed intersection, all the energies of travelers, shoppers, banking, grocery shops meet. You can actually have no car, plenty of public transportation. If you live in the vicinity of Coolidge Corner, get your errands done, food shopping, etc. As a movie theater, Coolidge Corner Theater, they have film festival every year and they play mostly indie films, so it's pretty popular. It's great for date night because there's plenty of restaurants. Bookstore was a paperback booksmith, so now it's called the Booksmith. It's been there for many years and it's the only one around besides Jamaica Plains Paper Cuts. That's a neighborhood bookstore. The parking is reasonable. There are parking lots behind all these storefronts and everything's metered. Unfortunately, it's a 2-hour limit on all the meters. Coolidge Corner itself is surrounded by side streets with lots and lots of condo buildings. These buildings were built between 1910 and 1926. They're big, solid buildings for people who rent apartments. They've been made into condo buildings. Any other buildings around there were either built in 1960s, like a tall apartment building, or the 80s, 1980s. Single families are rare. There are some side streets. They were built in the late 1800s, early 1900s, and one of the side streets has John F. Kennedy's birthplace. As far as real estate in Brookline, Coolidge Corner area, right now it's a little bit different than most of Boston. It's not as competitive and most of the places sell for 97 to 99% of asking. Now, right now, everywhere else is selling for 100, 101, 102%. So I'm gonna give you numbers for the last 90 days in the Coolidge Corner area. 90 days, late October to November, December, January 2021. 99 condos were sold. Out of those, the average days until they got an offer were 45. Now, it can be 15 or 20 for a lot of other neighborhoods. Average days on market, 57. And the average sale price of a condominium out of those 99 were $1,076,000. The lowest was $350,000 for a studio. There's a diverse studios, one bedrooms, 2 to 3 bedrooms. The highest was $3.025 million. Right now, the end of January, there are 16 condos on the market and 2 are new in the last couple days. So today is late January. In the last 2 days, the ones that came on, the average price is $1.6 million. The median price of what's on the market now, the 14, $843,000. The median days on market, 71 days. you can look around without feeling the pressure. If you're interested in Brookline, now's a good time to buy. So that's my focus on Coolidge Corner in Brookline, Massachusetts. A great neighborhood, great place to visit, and a great place to live if you don't want to have a car. Now, one thing about Brookline, there is no overnight parking at anywhere in the town of Brookline. So you need to have a parking spot if you have a car. But Coolidge Corner area, you don't need one. You're right on the trolley line. You can zip into Boston. You can be in Fenway Park in 10 or 15 minutes. It's pretty great. You can also get to the Mass Pike in 10 minutes. You can get over the BU Bridge and hop on the Mass Pike. So it's a great little place. If you're interested in any questions on this town, please send me a little message below. All my contacts in the detail section below. And most of all, I'd love you to subscribe. I post every single Wednesday. See these other little videos? You might be interested in checking out some of the local towns. Thanks so much for watching.